Hello students, today our topic is field effect transistor. The field effect transistor is a three terminal unipolar semiconductor device in which current is controlled by an electric field. FET is a unipolar device, that means current flowing through it is only due to one type of charged particles, holes or electrons. Construction of N-channel junction FET. The structure of N-channel junction field effect transistor is shown in figure. A semiconductor bar of N-type material is taken and ohmic contacts are made at the two ends of the bar. These are the terminals named drain and source as shown in figure. On both sides of N-type bar, heavily doped P regions have been formed by alloying or by diffusion to create a PN junction. Both these PN junctions are connected together and via an ohmic contact the gate terminal is brought out. The supply voltage is connected between drain and source terminal of a junction FET. Hence, current is caused to flow along the length of N-type bar. This current is due to majority carrier, which in this case are electrons. The symbol for N-channel junction FET, the arrow on the gate terminal indicates the conventional current directions. The channel is N-type material between two gate regions. The majority carriers electrons move through this channel from source to drain. Since the channel is made of N-type material, this FET is called N-channel FET. The electrons enter the channel through the source terminal and leave through the drain terminal. Construction of P-type junction FET. The construction of P-type junction FET is shown and its symbol is shown in figure. This figure, and the only difference between the P-channel and N-channel junction FET is that a P-type semiconductor bar is being used with two N-type gate regions. In P-channel junction FET, current flows due to holes. This is because holes are majority carriers in P-type semiconductor bar. In N-channel junction FET, current flows due to flow of electrons. Next is operation of N-channel FET. The operation of N-channel FET can be understood with the help of diagram. And before considering the operation, let us consider how the depletion layer is formed. How the depletion layers are formed. Consider the effect of drain voltage, drain battery VDS while VGS is removed. Suppose that this VGS is removed. The voltage VGS, VDS is dropped across the N-channel resistors RDS. And giving rise a drain current ID is equal to VDS by RDS. Due to this current flow, there will be a uniform voltage drop while going from drain to source. This is shown in figure B. Consider the two points A and B in the N channel. Let VA and VB the potential drop at this point, means VA is the potential drop at the point this and VB is the potential drop at the point B. Certainly VA is greater than VB. So the reverse biasing effect on the P channel junction FET is stronger near the drain than that near the source. Due to this reason, the penetration of depletion region at the A is more than B. This explains why the depletion region extends farther into the channel at the point A than at the point B. When suppose both VDS and VGS is applied. When no potential is applied between gate and source and simply a potential VDS is applied between drain and source, a current ID flows from drain to source, which is maximum because channel is widest. let gate is reverse bias by applying a VGS between gate and source. This gate bias increases the depletion region, thereby decreasing the cross-sectional area of N channel. Due to decrease in cross-sectional area, the drain current ID decreases. When gate current is further increased, a stage is reached when two depletion region almost touches each other and drain current becomes zero. So according to a fixed drain to source voltage, the drain current is function of only reverse bias voltage at the gate. And since negative gate voltage controls the drain current, FET is called a voltage controlled device. Thank you.